At this new centre for tech startups in Paris, João Cardoso gets down to business with his team. The online entrepreneur planned to base his latest venture in London, but after Britain voted to leave the European Union, he moved to France.
When we went to London and could really feel on our skin the Brexit environment, the uncertainty around the rules, it became obvious to us that it could not be the choice. We need to be in continental Europe.
Called Station F, this is the biggest tech startup hub in the world. It's part of France's drive for Paris to replace London as Europe's business and financial capital after Brexit. The government's already cut taxes for high-income earners and loosened the rigid work laws. And in July, Paris officials also stepped up their campaign.
Aux investisseurs.
To investors disappointed by Brexit, I'd like to say to you that we are ready to roll out the red, white and blue carpet. Welcome back to Europe, welcome back to the Paris region.
The French push for Paris seems to be working. More than 30 companies have already relocated from London to the French capital. And there were celebrations in November when the European Banking Authority announced that it would place its headquarters here. But some experts warned that France could have more to lose than to gain from Britain leaving the EU.
Those here say Brexit will have a negative impact on France's economy.
I'm afraid Brexit is a bad thing. Our first customer for France is the UK. We actually have a £12 billion positive balance between the two countries. So anything which will impact the economy in the UK will impact our economy.
Entrepreneur is a new France.
For many bosses, choosing Paris isn't only about Brexit. It's also about France's new president, who sees innovation as the key to economic growth.
Macron has done a real revolution. And it's a soft revolution, but he is clearly engaged in a very, very good way for France.
It's still more than 1 year until Britain officially exits the EU, but the uncertainty of what will happen after is likely to see more businesses like this cross the English Channel. Natacha Butler, Al Jazeera, Paris.